Not sure yet. Hey, how's it going, guys? G1 Hextron here, and this is Cybercast Episode 108, the Transformer Podcast Show. We've got a special one for you guys today. We didn't have a show last week just because I was sick and Jaim was out of town. So we're going to double up on this episode. So I'm joined with my co-host, Jaim, also known as Victory Saber 77. Dakota, PrimalSabbath, has also came back. He was going to be with me last week since he wasn't. Pete's here. We're going to have him on again. And Pete Sinclair from Botcon and also the Collectors Club. So, how's everybody doing?
Good. Pretty good, yeah.
All right, so before we get into the plugs and everything, Jaim has a few shows that he wants to announce and also our collection spotlight, so I'll let him get into that.
Yeah, we have the Aftercast, which will be airing on my channel, Victory Saber 77 on YouTube. It's every Saturday at 9 p.m. Central Standard Time. And we do have the collection spotlight that we do every week on the Cybercast. So if you want your collection spotlighted, no collections too small or too big, just send your pictures to g1hexatron@gmail.com. And this week we're going to be taking a look at Ultra Vengeance collection, and we're also looking for sponsorship. So if you want to sponsor the Cybercast, just email josh@g1hexatron@gmail.com.
And where can they find you, Jaim?
They can find me Twitter and YouTube, VictorySaber77.
All right, Dakota, where can people find you, man?
PrimalSabbath everywhere.
There you go. Primal Selfish. And you can find me, G1 Hextron, on Twitter, YouTube, Instagram, and my Facebook page is the G1 Hextron. Everything we're taking a look at today is found on that Facebook page. And we're going to go ahead and jump into our guest spotlight with Pete. Where can people, like, everything they need to know about Botcon? You got a Facebook page, you got a Twitter, the website. Where can people go to find those things? And I'll make sure that I put them in the description after the show.
Well, you know, obviously botcon.com, we've got a FAQ on the page, FAQ, that tells you kind of, you know, all the running questions. You know, we get a lot of questions, whether we get them through social media or just email to us. So you can go on there and kind of get a lot of the answers for the actual questions about the show. As far as we can find us every day, just with normal stuff, we're on Facebook, Twitter, we've got the website, and then I peruse the boards too, Cybertron, TFW, all the part. So I'm usually somewhere.
All right, I guess I'll start off with the first question, and then we'll just kind of go every other person here. But the first one I want to start off with is, now that things are up and running on the website, what's all available for, you know, the fans to sign up for and take advantage of?
Yeah, I'm so trying not to dodge questions, but I've got my son with me tonight, and unexpectedly, so just give me 20 seconds. I'm so sorry.
All right. I guess we'll address
this. Kick off the PrimalSabbath block. You can see I'm here. Barren shelves behind me.
I got people in the chat. Is very excited to have PrimalSabbath on. This is my boy.
So I cry like that at BotCon. I expect lollipops.
Sorry, I'm back.
Give people an opportunity to kind of look and see what you have in your collection back there so they can already start being like, hey, what's going to be in the attendees and stuff like that. So,
yeah, all the 2016 Botcon toys are right behind my head. 2017, no, kidding. But,
G1 molds.
They're all G1 molds, yes.
It's funny. People that, just not to, you know, sidetrack right from the start, but a lot of people do kind of ask about the G1 molds if we have access, and we do. It just kind of depends on what Hasbro's doing, and you know, there's been so many times that those molds have been used, so what exactly would you do with them? But we're open to ideas. If people really would like us to maybe use the G1 molds, I mean, we're definitely open to it. So
I'm all about that. I'd buy several box sets. I love that idea. Box set G1, all attendees. That'd be great. That'd be the perfect BotCon.
All right, I'm sorry, so I'll let you get back to it here. I'm so sorry. If I have to dip away, I promise it'll only be for like 20 seconds, but I usually don't have my son on Saturday nights, but mom had a bridal something or another, and I never say no, so.
There you go. All right, so now that things are up and running, what's available for the fans on, you know, that they can take part of? You have something new with the VIP experience. You got the golden ticket. There's several different packages. What's all available for the fans as of right now?
Well, you've got the golden ticket package, which will get you, that's kind of like the premier package that gets you the Friday night meet and greet get you three times. You get to buy three times the souvenirs, and we've cut the souvenir numbers this year substantially because we want to make sure, you know, supplies meet demand and we're not kind of, you know, overproducing. So it's a really good benefit for anybody who's coming to the show but also has other people they want to buy for, because we usually do limit up to one each. So you get the three times the limit, you get the meet and greet, you'll get a signed print from Frank Welker, Sue Blue, and John Machida. You will get VIP seating at all, the golden ticket seating at all the panels. So for the Frank Welker panel, of course, that'll be the most probably packed panel probably more packed than Hasbro's. So you'll get that front row seating there for that. You get early package pickup on Wednesday night, and you get to go in first to the showroom and all the panels. So you always get first crack at everything, including this tour.
Jaim, you want to go with the next one, man?
Yeah. What kind of perks do you get with the Frank Welker VIP experience that you wouldn't with the golden ticket?
Yeah, and then I guess I didn't finish. I got stuck on the golden ticket. So the other package is the VIP ticket or VIP pass. So you have, as of right now, you have to be a Primus package holder or a golden ticket Primus package holder to get the VIP ticket, and that gets you an autograph in person with Frank. You get either personalized or just, you know, generic signature. It will get you a pro photo, so we'll have we've got a photographer coming in from Chicago. We'll have the big backdrop, just like you see in like all the other shows where they have the big celebrity guests. So you get the pro photo, they'll print out a 5x7 photo you'll get right there, and then we've got an amazing print that was drawn by Casey Collar and colored by Josh Perez. It's absolutely incredible. And then you get a really cool lapel pin. It's a Megatron pin, and I think it looks fantastic. I think people get a kick out of it. It's a very interesting design, so definitely pays tribute to Megs. So that's your VIP ticket. Then, of course, you got your mini cons for Golden Ticket and regular Primus. You got Protoform, which gets you everything except the dinner and the toys. So those are your four main packages. Then, of course, you got General Mission. Nobody wants to come as a Primus.
Now, you still have the VIP and the Golden Ticket. They're still available as of right now, as far as you know.
Yeah, we upped the number on Golden Ticket this year. We added a few more in. We do have both. We kind of make sure the Primus packages are loaded heavy, so we don't have as many in the non-attending. And then every year we start to kind of move some to non-attending as we kind of gauge how many people are going to be there. With us being back in the Midwest for the first time, we weren't sure, you know, so we want to make sure that was loaded heavy. Make sure we definitely have anybody that wants to come to the show can definitely get their pass to the show. So, the non-attendings are already moving fast, and we'll have to load some more into there depending on what the demand is for attending.
I had a question to kind of piggyback on the Golden Ticket and Welker experience thing. I noticed when running through registration, I just kind of like go back and run through every now and again and see what all is still available since it went live. You pick Golden Ticket and you get to the Frank selection. It shows that it's sold out for Saturday, but if you go pick Primus and you go to the Frank selection, it says that it's still available for Saturday. I thought that was all kind of the same allotment.
Well, that's just how we allocate the numbers.
I guess.
We want people. We would prefer Primus and Golden Ticket to definitely fill up Friday first, because you don't want the schedule. We've worked on the schedule to make sure that you're not really missing anything if you do your signature on Saturday, but it makes a lot more sense as a Primus or Golden Ticket member to do your signature on Friday, because the time we have doesn't really take away from anything else going on. So, you know, why not do your signature when there's nothing else going on Friday, as opposed to Saturday where you're going to miss a couple panels, the dealer room is going to be full. So we're trying to make sure Friday fills up, and then not that we already have a bunch of people signed up for Saturday, but we're trying to, you know, lean people towards Friday, so we've kind of loaded the Friday tickets heavier. That's why Saturday sold out, right?
I got you.
Dakota, you want to go to the next?
I guess that makes me on the third question. Yeah. What is the hotel shuttle situation with this year? You know, last year, you know, for the Pasadena location, we had, you know, Super Shuttle, you know, took us about the same distance from LAX to the Pasadena Convention Center. And this year, it's like, it was just barren, you know what I mean? It was on top of a lot of people's fears list, I guess, for this year.
So I'm going to totally pull a Marco Rubio moment and just, like, take my drink of water. Not really. I'm going to go grab my kid real quick, just check on him. That sounds like I'm totally dodging your question, but I actually have a full answer to that. And give me just 30 seconds. I'll be right back.
All right, we'll address one of the questions in the chat. This is from Minifigure Collector. Question, what are your thoughts on the Trypticon reissue with the rare gun? We're going to be taking a look at the reissue Trypticon here after we get done with, once we get into the screen sharing part of the show. So we will take a look at, like I said, everything. Hasbro, Takara, Masterpiece, third-party add-ons, all that good stuff. We also got a couple of topics for you guys towards the end. But as far as rare gun with Trypticon, are you just talking
probably
about
full tilts? Yeah.
Full tilts gun? Yeah, it's going to come with it. So it's going to come with all the stuff. It's going to have electronics. It's going to have the... it's going to be just like an original. So it's going to have all the good stuff. It's going to be $200 and release... Is it July?
Yeah.
It's up for pre-order at a couple of the online retailers, so if you guys want to check it out. But $200, some places do free shipping, so... Oh, what's going on, Pete?
I wonder, kind of curious question, maybe I'll ask Pete later on, but first day pin, since there was a hiccup on the registration.
At least for the first couple of days. I think they said, I know they tweeted it out, but I'm kind of curious about that, too.
Like, who gets the first day pin, or... Because I know a lot of people are, like, that's one of the, like, the perks. Like, I want all the pins.
Come here. Did he answer the Super Shuttle question for me? Can we go to the next one? Are we good?
No, just a lot of smiling.
He said private limo.
Okay, so the question is, what's the deal with the shuttles? So that seems to be the biggest concern question. You know, this is kind of how I was thinking about it actually today, as we put up some more information on the shuttle. Botcon's kind of a unique show in that we do move around the country. So if we were in Pasadena every year, we'd obviously have it as a fine-tuned machine as far as how you got to and from the airport. Everything would be set every year. There'd be no issue. With Botcon, because we do want to move it around every year, there's obviously going to be challenges with every show. Usually we don't run into anything. Usually it's fine. Usually we've got the transportation all set up, so there isn't an issue. Usually there is a shuttle service. But just with this year, coming back to the Midwest, the timing involved, the locations that were available, the strength of the economy that kind of dictates what locations are available based on the time frame that we have to actually book the show, it just doesn't always work out exactly how we want. So with St. Charles, even though it's the same distance from Chicago O'Hare as Pasadena is from LAX, miles-wise anyways, it just didn't – there wasn't an actual shuttle service that's like complimentary or something provided by the hotel – just during, you know, due to the location. So we kind of looked in and found the best options we can. We've got the, obviously, you know, you can use the public transit. If you're not, you know, if you want something that's a little bit more, you know, personal, a little more comfortable, we did research and found four or five different good car services that really actually work out to about the same price as even a shuttle service that you have to pay for through a hotel if you book it with a couple friends, obviously, or family. So this situation is obviously ideal for families, groups of friends, if you're traveling with just some other people that you know from the show or that you know from online, you know, book with them, and then it works out to about $20, $25 a person. So that would be the option I would suggest, again, for anybody that's traveling in groups, families. If you are traveling individually, we still are working to see if there are any options. Obviously, with the registration issues that were there, it kind of put that to the back burner a little bit, though we still were looking into it. But again, we just can't make it happen. So if there is an option, we will bring that up, but right now, or we will, you know, make that available. But as of right now, the best options we have are on the website. So, but if we've got anything else, we will definitely do that, because we want to make it as convenient and as easy as possible. So,
kind of piggybacking off of that, now the hotel block for the hotel that the convention's at, is it sold out?
Yes, the blocks, the hotels all sold out very fast. All the surrounding hotels sold out fast. Now there are plenty of other hotels that are within 20 minutes. I don't know all the surrounding areas off the top of my head, but I was looking into that just for other reasons. So there are places, depends on your level of comfort that you want. If you want the cheap places, there's definitely places like that. If you want something a little nicer, that's more on the level of what we do for BotCon, there are places within 20 minutes. But this is why we always say, when we put up the hotel information, as soon as we have it, because we want you to book early and make sure you have your room. So that's what we got for hotels right now.
That goes as well. I don't know. There's probably always cancellations as well with some of this hotel stuff. So when's a good time to kind of like start checking for cancellations? Like 2 weeks prior, 1 week prior?
Yeah, I mean, I think honestly at this point, I think people are going to be on there. If they're are gonna have their rooms, and they're probably pretty set at this point. So I think the time to check for cancellations probably would have been a couple weeks ago.
Okay.
But I wish I had better answers for that. All I can tell you is we just have a lot of people that are booked, a lot of people that are planning on coming. So and that doesn't even take into account everybody that's driving in with being back kind of in a more of a central location. But I just wish I had a better answer for that. So I wish we had another 200 room nights, but we don't.
So for you guys that are like still wanting to go, or some out there and wanting to go, and maybe
you're having
to go to a 20 minute hotel, yeah. I would try to check on some of the Facebook communities or some forums, just the online. And there's probably a lot of people on there that are like, hey, I'm willing to split a room or something like that. You might know them on the boards or something like that. So maybe you guys can work something out.
Yeah, and I mean, like I said, I was on there a couple weeks ago and was checking all the surrounding areas, and there's a lot of rooms in that $110 to $130 range. And that's, again, for on the BotCon, where we like our room reviews or stars to be. So that's, there's plenty of those, 20 minutes away on a Saturday. Now, traffic isn't, people are just like, we've been here for years. Come to Chicago. Come to the Chicago area. We want you in this area. We're here, but you have to take into account traffic. So Friday's going to be a little crazy, obviously, but Saturday shouldn't be as bad, I wouldn't think. Like I said, just go to Google Maps. I was looking at it. A lot of them are just straight shots. You can either take the state routes, or I think there is a one of them, one area that comes from the highway. But if you were going to be at the show on Saturday, morning, you want to be there by 8. You leave at 7, you're fine. You get there with plenty of time. You park and so on. So.
All right, we'll go ahead and move on to the next one. Now, like I kind of explained earlier, on the show we look at a lot of official stuff, but we also look at a lot of third-party stuff, and I think our viewers, they kind of like a little bit of everything. We do have some hardcore third-party fans. Recently, put a post on there that says, no more third-party items in the dealer room. Can you kind of explain why dealers won't be allowed to sell third parties or third-party items in the dealer room this year? And kind of go, I guess, elaborate a little bit on what is allowed and what's not allowed, if you would, just for anyone out there that maybe had some questions about it.
Well, one thing when we did our meetings back in January at Hasbro, it's obviously it comes up, and one thing I actually said was I'm not really comfortable using the term third party anymore, because it's become this generic, all-encompassing term that I think makes a lot of people who are doing things like add-ons almost feel like they've been caught in this big net, like they're somehow being looked down upon by, you know, the licensees or the licensors, and that's not the case. We don't have a problem with third-party items. Hasbro doesn't have a problem with third-party items. The issues are anything that could be considered, you know, infringing on their IP. You know, this would be at any show. If Mattel had a show, if, you know, Robotech had a show, if anybody had a show and it was sponsored, you obviously don't want to see things that are kind of, you know, kind of, you know, I'm not sure exactly what term I want to use right now for that, but things that are not, we're not comfortable with. So
unofficial.
Yeah, unofficial. Things that aren't licensed. Things that, you know, there's a lot of gray area, and sometimes there's no gray area. Sometimes you look at it and you go, oh, hey, that's Megatron. So we just ask that those things are not on the showroom floor. It's I know people have posted online and there's been a big uproar about it, but it's really not a big deal, and it's really kind of simple. This is Botcon. This is a Transformers convention. We would just prefer and ask that vendors only bring licensed material to the showroom floor. You can't control, you know, anything outside of what's inside of our convention. And that's just kind of the way we look at it. And there's no animosity. We've talked to the dealers. I mean, they're fine with it. I've talked to the big dealers. They understand. They're not, like, up in arms about it. Everybody kind of gets it. So, you know, it's been made a bigger deal, I think. And I think some of that goes back to 2012. That's what we tried to clarify right from the start this year, but it's not a huge deal for those that are, like I said, selling to the show. We've got all the same dealers there. We've got Toy Store will be there. TF Source will be there. You know, like a Toy Fan will be there. Tempting Toys will be there. So we've got all the regular same big dealers will be there, and there will be tons of great Transformer items on the floor. There's 30-plus years of Transformers product. You can't find something that some people say there's not going to be anything on the showroom floor if they don't have third-party stuff or IP stuff. I'm like, no, there's 30 years of Transformers stuff. What do you mean? I mean, good grief. I would hope that there'd be something there for you to buy. So.
Now, they're obviously still going to have their room parties. That's something that's just, you know, that's really great with Botcon is just, you know, the room parties and stuff like that. So they'll be able to do what they'll be able to do what they want because, like you said, they don't have any control outside of the dealer room. Okay.
Yeah, sorry, I just fixed it so you don't see a big giant light on my face.
Okay. but like you said, you don't really control anything outside of the dealer room. So people are still allowed to go to the hotel parties and do whatever they want there. And, you know, if they sell third party, then they sell third party. But just going to be officially licensed stuff by a Hasbro Takara in the dealer room.
And there should be, I would hope there would, you know, one thing I missed from the old days. You know, it was back in, you know, the late 90s and maybe even still in the early 2000s was just some of the vintage stuff you would see. And I know that one guy that's come in who has not been to Botcon, I'll give him a plug. He goes by, I guess, by I Am Ratchet.
Oh, and yes.
I've seen him at local shows. He usually has some incredible vintage stuff, AFA graded. I guess he's raffling off of sealed Fort Max or something, so... I mean, he'll have some amazing stuff. There's another guy, he's going to give me a hard time for blanking on his name right now, but he's going to have some, I know he's setting up for the first time, I believe, at Botcon, the first time in a while, and he's got a ton of vintage stuff. So there should be all kinds of great items on the floor, from modern stuff, masterpiece stuff, to the vintage stuff. I mean, there will be a wide selection, as always. So.
Okay, just one follow-up to that. Is this the way that it's going to be from now on? Because I just wanted to make sure, like, because 2012, there was that thing, and then it wasn't, you know, so exact, but this year, you know, it is, like, it's not going to be allowed on the floor.
Well, there was...
That way going forward, or was there something that happened in 2012? Or, not 2012, but...
Nothing happened. I think there was just a little bit of a... hi, bud. There was just a little bit of a communication challenges when I think Hasbro kind of, there was some mix-ups with the team. Not mix-ups with them, I mean, just there was some mix, the team was being changed around a little bit, and I know the IP team had changed. So, you know, sometimes we have to make sure we have the actual direction from them on what we are and are not enforcing. But we've got a real clear understanding for this year and for going forward.
Okay. Cool. That's all I had for that. Jaim, you want to go ahead?
Yeah, what made you decide to go with the figures you chose for the box set?
What was it? No, I'm sorry.
What made you decide to go with the figures you chose for this box set?
You know, usually, Xander, hold on. Hey, come
on. If you guys have any questions that you'd like us to ask, you can put them in the chat. And if they're Pete questions, then we'll get to them. If they're Brian questions, then obviously Brian isn't here, so we wouldn't be able to answer them.
Dude, I would like to show with Brian.
You would.
Yeah, he could say that that's a Pete Sinclair question.
They just go back and forth. And our mystery guest is.
Dude, I mean, you know, Josh, me and you, you know, we're so close to Dallas-Fort Worth, we could probably just go like. Sit on his front porch on a hot summer day, drinking sweet iced tea, and have the podcast that way.
Now you know I'm out of Cincinnati, right?
No, we're talking about Brian.
Oh yeah, yes, people. He has fans over all the time.
Exactly.
It's over all the time.
Only like 2.5 hours away. We'll do a Cybercast like live from you know
the Savage Ranch.
Yeah,
his front yard.
So this year's toys. Let me remember. Let's see. We got.
You got Battle Trump.
Yeah, I'm trying to remember who came first. I think.
It was the Rat.
We all know it was Pack Rat, the superior of the box set.
The superior of the box set.
Now the Pretender's the best one out of the box set.
I don't remember. You know, unfortunately, in my old age, my memory is not what it used to be, and I sometimes have a hard time remembering how. Because I mean, this was like. We start talking these ideas back in, when this had been spring of, not even last year, this would have been fall of 2013, we would have started talking about this set, because we're already done, because 2016 is already all decided on and ready, and we'll start talking 2017, probably by August. So, yeah, so I guess it would have been fall 2017. Now, we had already... Battletrap was actually... We wanted Battletrap to be a pirate. And he got the boot. No pun intended. So, he was not... That mold was not available to us at the time. So, he said it was great. I love... Sometimes they're... And I'm not dogging on them. Sometimes when we got back the feedback for the pirate set, they told us, you know, which ones we couldn't do. And it said... said Battletrap, you can do the character, but you can't do the mold. We're like, well, if you can't do the mold, I mean, we can't. What are we gonna do Battletrap from from the Skids mold or something? So I don't even have it announced yet. But anyways, so Battletrap was still on the table, and I think about the same time we were talking about, you know, kind of the success of the 2014 set and wanting to. Not necessarily be constrained by a theme, just with where we were with the mold selection we had and the ideas we've already done. So I think the idea was, okay, we had already done the Pirates, and it worked out pretty well, and you know, the set sold out, and it was actually the highest number. It actually was, the highest number set we'd ever done, or tied with the highest number sets we'd done. So we wanted to do a theme that where we could kind of capture everything. So the theme kind of came first. So I think it was kind of the theme... was, okay, Battletrap's really wanted by people. You know, everybody's like, that's an automatic. And then we thought, well, okay, so let's do, you know, that was kind of, the Cybertron's most wanted is obviously, you know, that's tied to the theme of what fans most want. So, you know, we thought, okay, you've got a Battletrap. We thought, okay, who else, so let's do a villain. So let's do Cybertron's most wanted. Let's do, you know, set it in Axiom Nexus. So we can pull from everywhere, and then we thought, well, who else do we do? Well, obviously, people already, as soon as they saw Rat Trap, were like, okay, Pack Rat, that makes sense. So we had Battle Trap, we had Pack Rat, and then I wanted Stepper. Stepper was I'll admit that Stepper is Pete's most wanted. So I know there's shattered, I know there's Shattered Glass people out there, and I you know, I understand some people think that there aren't any Shattered Glass fans or that the team's kind of been worn out, but we still get a lot of people that are very excited about the Shattered Glass stuff, so that I felt was a good opportunity to get him in there, kind of use a great mold in Jazz, and also to kind of do kind of a fix from a goof from 2008, when we just ran out of time and the Ricochet colors weren't what we really wanted in the end. But again, we get a new character, Stepper. So you get those three, and the next, I think Megatron came next. I think we were looking at Motormaster from the Breakdown mold. I think we were looking at Motormaster, Wreck-Gar, and Megatron. Megatron was, I suggested Motormaster, but then Jesse Wittenrich, who I worked with, he did mock-ups, and he submitted three. He submitted it as Motormaster, Megatron, and as Wreck-Gar. And Megatron jumped right out at me. I was like, oh my gosh, you got the truck. You can totally do an homage to the movie 3 Megatron. You know, so he made perfect sense. And then we were thinking, okay, what are we going to do to top the Headmaster? And then that's when the idea to do an all-new Pretender shell came out. And that was just...
That's my favorite.
Yeah, he just turned out... I mean, he's got... I mean, I know I've done the videos, so you've already seen all this, but the fact that he's got the ports on the back, he can hold both weapons, he's a double Pretender, just like the original toy, or the original prototype. My backpack's starting to break already, because I've messed with it so many times. So, as soon as we kind of figured out this one, and thought, if we can pull that off, I mean, he's the monster, too. I mean, he is huge. I don't think people really are going to fully realize what a pun intended beast he is until you actually get him in hand. I mean, he is just, I mean, he's so wide and he's just like a beast. So.
To piggyback on that, are there plans to kind of keep topping, you wanted to top Scorponok, so you made Oil Master. Is there any plans to top Oil Master, or is it like going back to conventional?
There was in a way. There was, but we have kind of what we're planning from our meetings with Hasbro this past January, where they're kind of wanting us to go and wanting us to tie into the brand closer. People always, and I'm not going to really go into detail, but it's always fun. People always kind of think they have it figured out. Well, Fun Publications can't use current molds, or they can't use this, or here's the rules. The rules are always changing. Which is fine. We can adapt. That's no problem. But right now, for a long time it was Hasbro did, you do your thing over here, and we'll do our thing over here. Well, now, there's a lot of, they kind of want a closer relationship, more brand unification, which is fine by us. So I think people are going to see something really cool and exciting for 2016, but I wouldn't say that there's anything in there that's going to top the idea of a Pretender or a Headmaster. Maybe down the road, we're working on some stuff in the subscription services. You might see, I wouldn't say topping, but maybe some more lateral moves. But as far as with BotCon, I think you're just going to see a little bit more of a closer tie-in to what the brand is, where they are at the time. So,
Titan class Metro Titan from the Metroplex mold. Just saying, it's out there. It's out there, Pete.
It's out there.
A one figure box set.
That would be it, yeah. Which is funny because I think I've said this. I think Hasbro said to us years ago they wanted us to reduce the box set number of molds we were using. This was a long time ago, like 7 years ago. So we suggested doing Fortress Maximus, and they're like, "That's 30 molds." Like you guys said, reduce the figure count. I wasn't thinking mold count, so like, no, less molds. So I guess it's like 30 molds before max. So yeah, there was a pitch where we had Fortress Maximus as the box set. But that was...
Shattered Glass, Fortress Max.
Yeah, I think this was... I think this predates the Shattered Glass. This might have been... I think this was back in 07, so...
All right, Dakota, you want to get to the next one, man?
What are we on, 6?
Yes, sir.
Okay. In your opinion, how does this year's box set stack up against, the last, 10?
Yeah, I'm not going to make predictions anymore because I get in trouble for that every time. For me personally, with the way the shell turned out,
I like this one better than last year, and everyone's pretty high on last year's, correct?
Yeah, I think it's the most cohesive theme, in a way, we've done since 2011. The fiction's a big part of it, and the comic is incredible, art-wise. Story, you all can decide that, but, you know, at least with the art from Matt Frank and Thomas Deere, the art's incredible. So I think when you see them on the page and you see them interact, and then you see them interact with the souvenirs and how it all works together, I think people will dig it. I think on their own, they're a great set. I think the fiction will give it even more of a, you know, your kind of Usual Suspects, your Guardians of the Galaxy, you know, kind of all those types of things. I think you'll see them as a team by the time it's over. Go ahead.
I was going to say, to piggyback off of that, it seems, you know, the 06 and the 11 sets were just the most resonating still, like, to this day, because they are teams. Are we going to look forward to seeing more team-oriented box sets in the future? Because, like, for those who aren't attending, a team is so much more ideal than half of one and half of the other. You know what I mean? Like last year's.
Yeah, I think without giving anything away, and not saying we did this necessarily intentionally, but I think I can say that the 2016 set definitely takes a little bit more of a cue from the 2006 and 2011 set than, say, the Machine Wars or the Shattered Glass versus Classic set.
Right.
So, to answer your question, yes, you'll see more of the Titan theme.
All right, so Beast Wars theme next year? Appreciate it? No. I'm busting your chops, man.
It's actually animated Beast Wars. You can't go wrong with that.
That's what I thought. You know, I was looking at someone's customs of that the other day. I was
like, merged form
the ultimate set.
The merge group, the Dinobot merge group. I'm sorry, my son, apparently he is just a ham and just wants to...
Well, that's fine. We only got a few more. There's a couple of viewer questions as well. I think we got about 30 in there. Last one that I had, there are some rumor attendee figures on the internet. Want to know if we can confirm any of those. Ones I'm talking about is there's a G2 General Optimus Prime, there's a black Diaclone style Skids, and then there
a
is
a quartet of Waspinators. Is there
yes, and some Waspinators. I mean, you can just give me a grin. I'll make sure we click on the video here. You can just kind of give me a smile. Okay. All right.
You know, a point I saw made on the AllSpark from a former person involved with Botcon years ago said something about how he thought the theme was a little bit more, it wasn't just the theme, but he thought maybe the souvenirs, there was going to be a most wanted aspect carrying over to the souvenirs too. And I don't think that was initially intended, but we always want to make things that are desirable and that people want, but I don't think we really thought of the most, especially with the one set, I wasn't thinking of it as being most wanted, but after seeing some reactions to things that may or may not, I'm like giving it away. There's some pretty awesome souvenirs. People are going to love them. I just want to pull them over right now. All right, here's the one.
Yeah. I mean, look, every time you come on Cybercast, you obviously get...
I know. I should have messed with you and just had a bunch of stuff painted up.
Something last time. That was great.
Oh, it worked out. It was funny watching everybody. I mean, you got the guy doing the, you know, thank goodness my camera, you know, was kind of, at least whatever, because of the lighting in the office sucks. And it was, I guess, summertime at the time, but you couldn't really get a real clear look. But the people were zooming in, and they had, like, the chalk lines around each one.
Yeah.
They're the best part was, pink is this guy, green is this guy.
We escaped it, we're okay. They didn't see the monkey. They totally missed the monkey, we're fine. And then all of a sudden, one day, someone's like, what's that thing back there? I'm like,
oh. Oh, it was already up before we even finished. Yeah, so.
But I thought we'd escape people realizing that there was a pretender shell, but yeah, it worked out, you know. You gonna answer any questions?
All right, Jaim, do you want to go ahead with the next one?
Next question. Will we begin to see a coherent long-term theme with BotCon stories, much like we did in the older days, or will we continue to see small one-shot portions that kind of fit into a larger universe?
Well, we kind of had that going on with the Wings universe, which was the G1 cartoon-esque continuity that would carry over from convention to club comic and back and forth. So, you know, sometimes we do the one shots like we do with the animated. Sometimes we do, I guess I can announce one thing real quick. We are doing a, if you guys want an exclusive thing to tell you, we are doing a Transformers animated script reading this year, and it is being written by Marty Eisenberg. So that will be pretty cool. So that will tie back into animated. But as far as the long term, I'm trying to think. You know, things are kind of up in the air right now. As again, I was saying earlier, the partnership's kind of changed a little bit with Hasbro, so I'm not exactly sure where we're going. It's still kind of in flux. But, you know, I'm not sure. It has in the past, and it hasn't. I mean, you know, the Wings universe we're pretty much done with. Axiom Nexus is great for one-shot stories. We've still got the Classics versus Shattered Glass thing going on in the club comic, and that'll continue for this year and probably next year. As far as convention stories, it's still kind of up in the air with what's going on with Hasbro, so all I can say is stay tuned on that.
Can I piggyback on that one more time?
You can piggyback as much as you want.
I'm a pretty big dude, so you probably don't want to say that. I can like eat my weight in sushi. It's ridiculous. Grilled cheese sandwiches.
No grilled cheese sushi at the Golden Ticket. Got it.
We have you know, the Beast Wars Uprising thing kind of going on. It's more or less in prose stories now. When will we see more of that? Will that also kind of sort of continue?
Yeah, we've got Jim Sorensen doing the prose stories now. I think we've got another one. I think Josh Bertram's doing the art on that. So we've got another. I think we've done two. Hey, I got to answer the question. Watch Titans. I think we put up two, and I think we've got one more coming. And Jim loves his cameos, and he really likes this universe too. So there's gonna be definitely some more. That's kind of how we want it. And this is the first year we've done this. Is actually done the club fig or the club free figure through the pro stories, and that's because we are setting something else up through the club magazine, which is pretty a pretty big event. One of the biggest things we've done in the club comic. So that's why he's actually in the pros, because he just did not fit. Because we wanted to keep telling that Beast Wars Uprising story, but for the club magazine, we wanted to focus on some other of our toy offerings. So, I think I already said that Nova Prime's going to show up. So. And if I haven't, there you go. Nova Prime's going to show up.
But he's not Beast Wars Uprising. He's Classics Shattered Glass.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Nova Prime is in the is from a different universe.
Very cool. I think that's a first.
Right. Dakota, you gonna go with 9?
Yeah, I'll go ahead and go with 9. Will we see more VIP packages or passes rather in the future, like for other high profile guests, like Colin or Wilbur were to return again? You know, how's that looking?
It all depends on how this all works out. You know, it's no secret that a lot of celebrities of varying, I don't want to put anybody on the list, but a varying list, it found a definite opportunity in conventions, and people have been very receptive to that. And of course, with that, that's, you know, there's a cost that comes with that. So if people for the BotCon audience respond to the Frank VIP pass the way that we need them to make it, you know, feasible, then sure. So right now it's looking good, but we just need to kind of wait to see what the final numbers work out.
Right. Okay, cool.
You're being such a ham.
Right, I'm going to go with the two-level question. It says, what molds are you not allowed to use in BotCon? I think you've kind of answered that before. You know, some of the ones that Hasbro says you can because maybe they plan on doing it, or like, but will you ever do a Masterpiece figure?
Yeah, we haven't really looked into that yet. Xander, you're getting out of control. We have not looked in. We've talked about it. I don't know yet. I think so. Okay, hold on. Xander. Stop. Let me talk for a second, okay? Let me talk for a second. Alright. The Masterpiece figures, with the licensing and all that, I'm not sure. Alright, we're getting a popsicle. I'll be right back. I'm sorry.
Come on. If you would grab me a popsicle as well, cherry's my favorite color. Pete, where are you going?
Trent, he says, has anyone else seen anything? Can you guys not see? Put it in the chat. Put a one if you can see everything. Everything's coming across clearly. Just put a one.
He's like, no, I'm talking about reveals. Yeah, I can see you guys just fine.
Oh, is that what he's talking about? Like a deep one? Here, I'll back.
Every time we get the opportunity, it's like shattered.
I know. I'm a little slow on the trigger.
Why does a picture of Gary Chalk and somebody keep coming up?
Oh, that's when I turn my camera off every now and again. That's me. That's me with a shaved head. I've had my head shaved for like the last 2-3 months.
Like, it looks like you're holding Gary up, and he's had just too much to drink, and.
You know, I wouldn't doubt it. That was 2012. So, you know,
I actually took that picture, and that was even before Cody and I even met each other.
Oh, here we go.
Anyways, we'll move on from that.
I was just talking with my mic muted. How dumb. Whatever. I mean, we'll move on from it.
Jaim, I think we got two more there, because one of those have already been answered.
Yeah, I think so. So we're done 9, 10, 12. Yeah, just about two more.
All right. All right, go ahead, Jaim. You can ask the next one, and then I'll get Coda, and then...
The Masterpiece, real quick. It's not on or off the table. It just hasn't really been brought up yet. We haven't heard a lot of people asking for it. I'm not sure what we would even do. I mean, I know there's options.
G2 breakdown.
The reason I'm looking up there is I'm just kind of looking at them, just kind of thinking about if we even really thought about anything. The licensing, I just don't know how. We just haven't looked into it yet. Sometimes I want to get more of an answer, even though I don't have one, and I'm bad about that. So I kind of ramble on. You know, who have they released over here? They released Prowl.
No, they haven't done Sideswipe over here yet.
No. Prowl, Optimus, Soundwave.
Seekers.
Grimlock, yeah, the Seekers.
Rodimus.
You know, so anything that don't really deal with any of the other than the Prowl. Because, you know, we had an alternator set plan, but with the licensing and all that, it just got real sticky. We had actually a really cool idea planned. And we just, you know, kind of, we were going to do Galvatron and Rodimus and Cyclonus and Ultra Magnus, and it was going to be a box set. But they just said no. So I think that was going to be for 2008, 2009, or 2007. No, 2008. It might have been 2008 before Shattered Glass. People tend to be Shattered Glass haters. Oh, man, we could have had all the news. So, you know, we'll look into it. It's not something we have on our plate right now. But, you know, we'll definitely look into it.
All right, cool. Next question, will you ever extend your ventures into add-on kits or maybe even other full-on figures, kind of like what you did with Oil Master? If there's not a mold out there that you want, would you ever create the mold?
And I'll say it just for shits and giggles. I would love to do, like, new Action Masters, but I don't know if there would be enough demand for it. You know, it's one of those ideas that's, like, in my head, I think that would be incredible, but then we would actually, and we'd put all that money into it, and then we'd only get, like, 750 orders, and I'd be like, ugh. So, you know, I think we'll probably do some more stuff like we've done with Oil Master and the Scorponok. We did have something planned for, I can't divulge it right now, we did have something that was going to be a major retool that did get kind of put back to the put back on the waiting list, which, you know, hopefully we'll get to do it in the future. So we still have things like that planned. As far as add-on kits, kind of leave that to other people right now. We're kind of happy with what you know, just with the amount of items that we have access to, the amount of molds we have access to. There's not really much reason for us to do, I guess, like a new weapon set or a new trail or something like that. We prefer to kind of do like the Creos. The Creo set I think is hilarious this year. I think people get a big kick out of that. So it's definitely something very different than what we've done the last 2 years, and it's gonna be much more inexpensive too. We got the because last year we did the micro changers, and they came with so many parts that the cost was just crazy. So we got the cost way down, and we did a concept that we think people are gonna find hilarious. It ties into the box set in a way, but
so you're telling me I'm gonna be on my first Creo venture this year. You're telling me I'm going to be on my first Creo venture this year.
Yeah, you might like them. I mean, I think people are even there's a neat little surprise, little art surprise that comes with it too for anybody that's followed the Creo stories online. So I think people get a big kick out of it. Like I said, I think it's just a little bit more than I don't should be solid prices yet, it's not going to be. It's going to be just a little more than half of what last year's set was as of right now, or, you know, about 60% of last year's price. So, yeah, that's all I got.
What are we on, 11?
Yeah, combine 11 and 12 together.
Yeah, let's do go together.
Okay. Can you share any information on souvenir sets like... perhaps cost, you know, that's a huge thing. A lot of folks are kind of, you know, what do I bring? Because like 2012, it was like right under 300. 2013, it was a little less. You know, last year it was like 350. You know, stuff like that.
Yeah, we haven't put up. We will do all the final pricing on that stuff this week. I've got the prices already kind of in my. I've already submitted what I think we should be charging everything based on what our costs are and what our margins are. We actually use a formula. Believe it or not, we use a formula for all this stuff. What our margins need to be, you know, what our final cost is. We will, for Joe, this past year or the past couple of years, we've given people that ballpark of what they need to bring. I can say this much. I don't want to say exactly what it is, but it will not be any more than last year. I can tell you that.
Okay.
It definitely won't be any more than last year. And I will go ahead and say you're getting one more. I'll say it. You're going to get one more figure than you did last year, too. So there's definitely, right?
So 8 altogether instead of 7 plus the freebie.
Yes.
Okay.
That does not mean that it's going to be 4 of the bugs. I did not confirm that.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I did it. It could be flywheels, and if it's not flywheels, there's going to be a reason why it wasn't flywheels. So,
should I even tell them like how cruel you're going to be like before the show went live? What you're going to do to these these people viewing.
Oh, yeah, I was going to... Well, I should have painted them up, but I could have had... Is that in? Is it right there?
Yeah. Right there on the corner. Just like last time, he was going to do this to you guys. I'll zoom. I have
him sitting right there.
Be like, hey, we're thinking about him on flywheels.
I mean...
Give us that one, Pete.
I don't want to say anything to make anybody mad, so I'm just not going to say anything. But
well, even if you shared, like, if let's say if it was, people would be mad that, like, you spoilt it from them. People like Dakota over here, you know, like, oh, you spoilt it for me. But there's also people that are like, hey, I'd like to know if it was going to happen. I think those two go together, Battletrap, Flywheels, just saying. Just putting it out there.
Yeah. You know, I didn't have. The funny thing is, I didn't have as a kid. I didn't have Battle Trap. I think until I was an adult collector, when I went back and filled in all the holes from the G1. I always had the flywheels, but I'm much more of, you know, in the camp of Battle Trap than flywheels from Blitzwing. But I don't know. He may show up someday.
All right, I got a...
Could be someday soon.
Find out in 2 weeks or a year in 2 weeks.
That's probably about right. You'll either find out in 2 weeks or you know, we'll talk about that stuff at the round table. And, you know, we have that feedback form, which is only two pages or two sides, you know, front and back. You know, if you all want flywheels, put it on the form. I'll... You know, if I get back to forums and there's only 20 people that said flywheels, I just confirmed we're not doing flywheels, didn't I? So
instead, guys, put on the form fractal. I have a huge. You see that big gaping hole on that shelf, like back there? That's where I need like seven fractals, seven transmetal fractals. That'd be great.
Transmetal fractals.
Yeah, he is a great looking. He is a great. I mean, that is a toy that probably needs to be done at some point. So. I will say we've had him. He has been on a couple different. He's made it to the. See, we have all different varying degrees. You guys know that panel I did last year, right? The 20 years 20 concepts. I think it was.
Yeah.
And I did 10 concepts that never made it to the, even to the submission stage. And then I did 10 concepts that made it to the submission stage, but either got booted before we submitted or after we submitted or whatever. And I think Fractal's been like, I think he's been at the submission stage like at least twice. And he just keeps kind of, for whatever reason, falling.
There's off. No love for him.
No, I think
there's too much love for him.
I think he's great. I mean, that's a. I don't know where that mold is. That's a great mold.
We don't need any Beast War characters.
Josh, you hush your mouth.
I need that G1 box set you were telling me about.
You need to finish the 3H Wreckers.
Yeah, I know. It's like, it's just that, it's
Fractal. It would be Botcon. It'd be BrickCon. That's what I'm talking about.
BrickCon.
Yeah, we're gonna do the little DevCon from. Mirage, or whatever that was from Beast Machines.
Thank you for giving us that as well. Yeah, I'll take that one too.
So, no, I mean, we've done like, I got to get the exact number. We've produced, we're pushing, I think, 160 now, 160 exclusives we've done since 2005. I mean, it's like 160 we've done since 2005, and yet there's still. Even with all of those toys we've done, there's still like it's hilarious that we like, oh man, we don't have a place for him, or oh, we don't have a place for him, because there's definitely things that we'd love to do. And if we were doing 40 toys a year, we'd be like, oh, we don't have a place for him, oh, we don't have a place for him. So, but I'll do what I can for you.
Yeah, I got one last question for you, Pete. This is from Trent5. He says, question, any chance ever seeing any Diaclone repaints? I don't know if he's just saying, like, one here and there, or if he's talking about, like, a whole entire Diaclone box set.
I thought I thought there's didn't someone just leak something online? Someone's putting out something.
Black skids. So
people have been asking for a box set of Diclones for a while, and I personally, and people disagree with me. That's fine. They'll say, "Oh, you think Machine Wars will sell, but you don't think Diclone will sell." Well, okay, so Machine Wars didn't sell either, but.
I like the Machine Wars for whatever that's worth. I thought that was a neat idea.
Well, we thought it was a neat idea too. Apparently,
we're all just in the minority here. Like, let us have our sweet Machine Wars universe.
I thought there were more fans who were super excited back in 1995, 96, whatever it was, going to KB Toys after they'd announced Beast Wars, and as cool as Beast Wars was. Going to KB Toys and seeing the flip changers and, anybody who was, well connected at that point into or well plugged into the collecting and fandom community through, whatever buddy you had over in England, knew about the European toys and seeing them repainted. I thought it was just fantastic. I thought, oh, we've got Beast Wars, but we're still getting our vehicles, and I just thought there'd be more nostalgia for that. And we didn't want to just do a straight-up redux of Machine Wars. We wanted to do a Series 2. We wanted to upgrade some guys, and Thundercracker was supposed to glow in the dark, and that didn't happen. That's a whole other story. But, so it was supposed to be like kind of upgrades from some of the guys from the first series, but then we introduced some new guys, like Obsidian and Stryka, who were both, generals. It would totally fit into a Machine Wars theme, and then we brought Electro in, and we thought, "Oh, this is great, great on paper," but it didn't resonate, and that's okay. It's gonna happen. But for Diclone, people have been asking for Diclones, and my thought has always been, as far as a box set went, you're not getting any new head molds. You're just doing repaints. If you're not someone who was really, if you're not that hardcore collector and you're not someone who is as familiar with Diclone or doesn't have a place for it in your collection, I hear that a lot. There's no place for that in my collection. So that's a concern too. Is there a place for it in the collection? There's going to be no Autobot symbol on it because it's not an. If you put an Autobot symbol on him, then he's no longer a Diclone. So could something like that work as a box set? I didn't really think it could.
Yeah, he says just here and there is what he meant. No box set is necessary. So
working as a two-pack souvenir set, I think that would probably work really, really well. So I guess we'll see.
I think so too. Do you guys have anything else for Pete before we let him go?
What's going to be for dinner at the reception?
At the Sinclair House?
No, I was just talking about the reception. Just the regular, not the golden ticket, just the. Because it's dinner and then the auction, right?
Yeah, we've got.
Brought up plastic, and he's been thinking about food since then.
I don't. It's like I know everything that's going on in my head, but I don't know what. I gotta make sure I'm not saying anything that hasn't been announced yet. So you have a dinner. We've announced that. There's no casino night. We announced that. There will be a cash auction.
Will you take cards at the cash auction, out of curiosity?
Yes, cool. Credit cards at the cash auction. We raised a ton of money for Cook's Children's Hospital at G.I. Joe Con this year. So hopefully we will raise even more money for Cooks County Children's Hospital at this year's BotCon cash auction. There will be a costume contest, and we've got something else planned that I do not think we've announced yet, so I'm not going to say it. But it's very cool. And people will love it. I am certain of that. As far as what's for dinner, hamburger helper, I think.
buffet style, or are they just going to bring it out on the nice plates?
Got that? We got that fake shrimp. You can buy it like your local Stop and Go.
But it comes.
You put that stuff on the grill; it's still good, man. Barbecue sauce it up.
That's disgusting.
I'm not sure what's for dinner, but it will. As always, if you have any special dietary needs, let us know at the dinner, and the convention staff will be happy to accommodate you.
My special dietary needs are three times everything. So,
All right, well, Pete, want to thank you again for coming on, man. I know it's just a few weeks out before BotCon, so and I believe you guys are going to be leaving for there in about another week or so.
I will be driving since I am close enough. We will be leaving a few weeks from Monday, so it is going to be we're pretty much good to go on everything. I think people are going to be thrilled at the offerings. I know, there's been a couple hiccups, to put it lightly, but we have all kinds of issues that surround that, and we will be happy to discuss that at the show in person. But as far as the show itself, if anybody's been to the show, especially the last few years, you're going to have a blast. The activities are all laid out. We've got tons of great people that are going to be there. Tons of great guests. Hasbro will be there, as always. People will have a blast. All your friends will be there. Celebrities are always very approachable. So that's always been a great thing. We will have a great store. We will have some, hopefully, exciting news about the plans for the store down the road, too, both online and at the show. So just lots of good things coming, lots of good things happening. So we're past the crazy week, and it should be all awesome from here on out.
Awesome.
Nice.
All right, well, thanks a lot for coming on, man. I appreciate it. And I guess Dakota, he will see you there. We will see you next year, but we'll probably talk, before then. So.
Well, I hope so. It's been a pleasure being on again, guys, and I'll see you soon.
All right. Later, man. All right, guys, we're going to go ahead and get into the screen share. Like I said, we've got about 2 weeks' worth of news. I've got so many tabs. We do have, once we go into video form now here with the screen share, the chat's going to be live to the right side of the screen. So if you guys would please, just because we do have families that do watch, so some young ones, if you would just keep, the language to a minimum, it'd be appreciated. So other than that, let's go ahead and get into this screen sharing stuff.
And real quick, I forgot to announce that Cybercast and the Aftercast next week, which will be June 7th, will be actually on Sunday. Same time, 6 p.m. Central Standard Time for the Cybercast, 9 p.m. Central Standard Time for the Aftercast. But we're going to be on Sunday. So,
all right. Can you guys see everything? Everything's coming across good? Yeah? No?
I can.
Yes. You can?
Okay, that's what I was asking. Okay, so the box art for box set, so you guys can see that, and the figures that are inside. We've looked at these all individually throughout the weeks whenever they've been released. But so you can kind of see everything that he was talking about earlier. You got Pack Rat. Was it Old Master? The Double Pretender here. You got the Shattered Glass Jazz. There is Battle Trap and the Dark of the Moon Megatron.
A lot of people are complaining about that price, but dude, look at everything you're getting for $400.
I want this so bad. I'm gonna tell Pete, give me that one that you have. All right, and I had. Oh my god, so many tabs.
Like, you're going to hear his computer start to bog up a little bit, as he's closing.
Yeah, whenever I was pulling up all this stuff, man, my computer sounded like I was taking a chainsaw to it. So some of the stuff that we were talking about earlier that is rumored to be, BotCon figures, you're going to be getting, one additional, wall spinners and stuff like that. So, again, rumored. What do you guys think? Yes, no?
I'm loving the Shattered Glass colored Waspinator or Transmetal Buzzsaw for those people all the way to the left. I'm really digging that one. Then there's the Halloween Horror Con Waspinator, the black and purple. Digging that.
I like this one.
The white one, like a lot of folks are thinking it's bug bite, but I mean, it's, I don't know, I was kind of indifferent to all the different waspinators, but then there's some that are saying the one to the far right, I thought that was like a transmetal waspinator homage, but some folks are kind of linking it to a diclone, some diclone toy that I don't know anything about. But it looks like all their heads are missing in the picture, the robot heads, so I'm curious what that's all about, but meh.
All right, some more rumored. All right, what do you guys think about flywheels? I think you're going to get a flywheels this year.
I don't know.
This is the black skids or the diclone skids.
Now, that's a custom.
This is a custom, but there was one earlier that looked like it was actually molded in the colors, but I couldn't find it, so I just kind of pulled this up to kind of give an idea.
Dude, the one that I saw, man, I think it looks pretty. You know, I never picked up that mold from the Generations line, and I kind of, you know, I'd wanted to, so the potential of actually having it is happy for me, you know, and I get to pay 3 times retail for it, like I like to do. And I'm looking, if that's a souvenir, I'm looking forward to it. I think it looks
Here is a custom, but there is one that's almost exactly like it. The head paint is a little bit different there, but it's basically a black skids. And whenever I was looking at it, this one, you can tell that there's paint. The other one that looked like it was molded in black and, you know, had some red and stuff in it. So
right.
I do think you're going to be getting one of this one as well. And then brings us to the last one. The G2 Optimus Prime. Oh, this is one thing I pulled from Cybertron. The G2 General Optimus Prime. This one obviously molded in these colors and tamper-graphed logos on it.
I hope we do get that, because I like the nod to the whole unreleased G2 thing. It really kind of fits Oil Master as well, something that was unreleased and only prototype. But I do kind of hope we get Sergeant Hound with him as well, that the white, whatever that Generations guy over there to the right of me is called. Scoop? Yeah, thank you. Kind of hope we get that too, but if we don't, I mean, we still at least got this, but I think those two would go together. It's a pretty cool pair. But I don't know. I'm digging that guy.
All right, and now we're, before we get into the collection spotlight, this is was it Ultra Vengeance? Had a little bit of movie news I wanted to go ahead and cover real quick. First off, Tron 3 will not be going into production, or at least for now. TMNT 2. Has two new characters confirmed. WWE's Sheamus, I guess that's his name, he doesn't have a last name, some wrestler, confirmed as Rocksteady, and then Brittany Ishibashi, probably saying that wrong, as Karai. Then you have The Legend of Conan, will have Arnold Schwarzenegger reprising his role. Hasbro hints at potential Transformers Bumblebee spinoff. There's also a Transformers 1 movie that is kind of a working title. It's in discussion and could be either animated or live action. It will focus on Cybertron before coming to Earth. So basically, you know, just think War for Cybertron, Follow Cybertron, the video games. Fox is going to be rebooting the League of Extraordinary Gentlemen. Dragon Ball Z Resurrection F coming to North American theaters in August. The movie Gambit will be an anti-hero story. And then World War Z Part 2, or whatever, the second movie, releases June 9th, 2017, and Brad Pitt will return. And the last thing on there is Blade Runner sequel will start photography summer of 2016. They were going to have Ryan Gosling, was rumored to kind of play the character that Harrison Ford played. Harrison Ford has now said that he wants to be, you know, come back as his role, so Harrison Ford's going to be in there again. And as far as TV, Ash versus Evil Dead will be 10 30-minute episodes and will be premiering on Starz fall 2015.
So, oh, nice. It's a new Starz show to get into.
This is the collection spotlight, like Jaim mentioned earlier in the show. You have a collection, you want to send it in. I've got another one in there. Forgot the name on it, but I talked to you earlier today on Facebook. I do have yours, so you'll see yours next week. But if you want yours to be spotlighted on the Cybercast, then send your images in an email, 10 to 20, to g1hextron@gmail.com. He's got third part. That's the cloud one. You just got this one, right, Jaim? Is that the cloud or is that a custom?
That's a custom.
Okay.
Or if it was the cloud, then he painted some of the parts on them.
Okay.
Dude, I want the cloud Robin so bad.
And there's these guys. Aren't these like getting like quite a bit of money right now?
Yes. They're nowhere near what they used to be.
Glad I hopped on that bandwagon, right?
Oh, look at all those Optimus.
Yeah, wow.
There you go. There's the best one right there.
You're pointing at the RID one, aren't you?
The fire convoy.
G1, right here.
Yeah, Generation 1 fire convoy. It was the only...
Oh, you're pointing at the Robot Masters in front?
Nope.
That one?
This guy right here. Nice masterpiece. God, man, I need him so bad.
He is nice.
All you guys, you always send in your collections, and every single one of you have MP10B. It drives me nuts that I don't have it.
Someone's just going to send one picture of their collection. It's just going to be MP10B.
Just a wall of MP10B.
Just 10 photos of him. So he's got a couple other things in here. Shockwave. That's a unique toys, right? The Galvatron.
Yeah. Oh, nice. Got the big convoy, Lyle convoy love. That's what I'm talking about.
And that's not G1.
Well, it's G1 universe. So.
And some Megatron G2. That's cool. I actually like this Megatron. I thought it was pretty nice. But that's a big Megatron right there. He said this is just part of his collection, so he had some other stuff, like here's some Dragon Ball Z stuff. You guys, whenever you send in your collection, it doesn't have to be just Transformers. We kind of like everything, so as long as you keep it. What did we say, Jaim, like 20 pictures kind of max? Yeah,
20 pictures max, unless you absolutely have just a huge collection, then you know, 22,
23. like a boxer for that.
All right, so like they've got this listed under like leaked Botcon stuff or whatever. I had this on Facebook. I just can't remember where I put it, but this has been featured in the IDW comics where they are going to be coming out with this paint job for the RC. So, guys, excited about that?
I hope it comes with that big Optimus sword. The cloud sword that's supposed to come with the
cleaver.
Yeah, that's
what I wanted to come with. Like this one, I don't even know if this one's like legit or not, but they are gonna be coming out with one like this. So I thought it'd just be better to look at than just the artwork.
You'd be awesome if it came with the Buster Sword, though.
Yeah, I was thinking about getting the Dark Azalea from Mastermind Creations, but now I can just get this version.
And then they're also gonna be doing a different paint job to Chromia as well. Dude, I hear you, Chevytron, man. I need that MP10B. It seems like everyone and their mother has one, and I don't. So. All right, getting into the other Hasbro stuff, some Kibana Wars. We get a look at Devastator. And got quite a few pictures of him. That's a nice picture. Someone transformed
that
him correctly.
That looks good. Like, I've kind of been meh with the Kibana Wars stuff, but if I had a place for it and I could afford it, man, I'd knock that Devastator. I'd get one right in my collection room. But I am still looking for Magnus.
Jaim, I know you like it, and you know, see some of the individual ones. We do have a comparison because of the San Diego Comic-Con is going to be coming out with the Devastator, and the purple parts are basically kind of like chrome. I think there's a few extra painting applications, so I think I'm going to end up getting the San Diego Comic-Con one just because I got a buddy that's going and said he'd pick me up one. But as far as height there, you can see it with the rest of them.
Golly, that thing is massive. Oh, wow.
And do have a few other pictures of the Devastator here. One with Metroplex. If that's what this one. Yeah, so it, you know, considered a Titan, not exactly as tall as, you know, Metroplex, but still it's
a good figure. I'm glad they did that, because it'd just be weird to have Devastator as tall as Metroplex. But yeah, that looks nice.
To all, I said he's not buying any Devastators with no zone, cape, and crown. That'd be an awesome add-on set.
I'm surprised no one's done that. The, what, 8, 9 generals?
Yeah.
And here you can kind of see the way that they're, you know, connect. So you can see that this connects into here, it connects in there as well. So kind of see the way that this is all configured. And now you kind of get a close look at them. And this is the one thing that I kind of hate, is because when I look at them, I have to remind myself that they're Voyager figures, because this looks like it's just a, you know, like a little Legends figure.
Yeah.
Because you see how thin those arms are.
Very hollow. Stuff.
Yeah.
Is that an elbow? I'm curious if that's an elbow.
That right there?
Yeah, is that an elbow?
Yeah. I think so. Looks like it's a swing hinge right there.
Yeah.
Still, meh. The combined mode is awesome, dude. That's where the money is. Like, you know my complaints about the other Combiner War stuff? Like, it's like they flipped around just looking at this guy.
The other thing is, you know, there's a lot of missing paint. Or not necessarily missing paint, but they're very greenish yellow. I would just like a little bit more, you know, details on them.
They look kind of like their animation models.
Because look at this. Like, when you look at this, it just looks like a yellowish-green brick, you know, on two black wheels. Or, you know, obviously four black wheels, but...
You like that, though, right?
That's what we got with G1.
Yeah.
I just want, you know, some paint details somewhere. Break it up. Maybe the San Diego Comic-Con will have that.
You know, Repro Labels will make a sticker set for it, too.
That's what's going to really help this. It's going to be expensive, too.
Jeez. Yeah, oh, yeah.
I just
the Hercules set was extremely expensive, and that, yeah, that's probably going to be expensive, too.
And I think this is going to be a comparison between the San Diego Comic-Con, yes, right there, and the regular retail release. So you can see that you're going to get a few extra little paint apps here and there, and also this is going to be kind of the purple. It's going to be chromed out.
That's getting the Takara makeover, essentially.
Now, the other thing that I see here with eyes, like, he's got the visor, and then he's got the eyes. So I don't know if that's something different, or do you think that he's going to have some kind of, like, pull-down visor?
I would think it'd be included, but, I mean, dude, you never know with SDCC.
I think it might be included. I mean, we got the visor with Metroplex.
I like the visor look better than I do the eyes, but I think I want this one. So, plus this is going to come out before this guy. So,
can't forget there's going to probably be some type of like Asian Comic-Con exclusive too of that.
Oh yeah,
just like they did with Metroplex.
It'll get released at Toys R Us as part of a Platinum something during the holiday season.
There'll be an Asian thing, and then there'll also be a Australia or Singapore or something like that.
Amazon, BBPS exclusive. Yeah.
All right, getting into some G1s. We've looked at this a couple of times, but now we get to finally see the back of it, and all the pictures are clear.
Oh, that's awesome.
So, getting that one. Now you can kind of see every bit of it. I'm going to buy this first because I need to make sure that all the colors are exactly the same. Like, I don't want these legs to be, like, a little bit, you know, any shade off of what the originals are. You know what I'm saying, Jaim?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I noticed that with the Encore, with even the originals, with the Encore releases, there is a little bit of difference.
If there's any, the slightest bit of difference, then I'm keeping them both. But if they're exactly the same, I'll probably just sell my originals and I'll just keep these. So.
Now, what is that extra piece that's with Perceptor? It's a backpack of some sort, but I don't know. What is that?
It's the thing that can hold his little slides.
Oh, the slide. Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's what it is. So it can actually attach to his back, which looks absolutely ridiculous. So I would just leave that off.
All right.
All right, so talk about the one that everyone... pull up. There you go. Trypticon. Man, the box art that they are doing for this Platinum Edition stuff is awesome. Love it.
Yeah, I don't think it's going to do too well.
What?
Now, this is probably the best anticipated re-release since Fort Max. Yeah, since Fort Max.
Now, you can buy Fort Max for $269. I was looking there at this week. Places still have it. They have it now for $269 and free shipping. This is going to be $200. Do you think that... I think that this one's going to sell.
Yeah, it will.
I thought that about Fort Max as well, but I think that they're not going to make it. I think they just kind of overestimated... the fans, you know, they just made too many of them.
Now, this is going to be a mass retail, correct? Or is this an exclusive to some certain retails?
I don't know. Usually the Platinum Edition stuff is Toys for Toys R Us, but I've seen some Targets, I think.
Target carried Pretty King, didn't they?
Yeah, Target or even, what is it? Not KB, Kmart?
Oh, yeah, I heard about the Insecticons being a Kmart.
Yeah, so we used to have a Kmart. It turned into a Hobby Lobby. Now, this is going to have everything that your original does, so it's going to have all the accessories. It's going to have all the light-up features and all the winding things. Dakota, what are you doing?
What am I doing?
I don't know. You're being noisy.
Sorry, I was just like moving a laptop around. I'll stop.
It's funny. The back picture does not have the picture of Full Tilt's gun. If you notice, Full Tilt does not have his gun anywhere there.
Okay, so I asked someone about that. I said, could anyone see Full Tilt's gun? Because I don't see it. And someone zoomed in, and they were like, yeah, there it is right there. So.
Yeah. It's just actually, the packaging doesn't have it, though, which is kind of odd.
I know, it scared the crap out of me, because I was like, I don't want two Trypticons and no Full Tilt guns. So I actually ended up this week, I bought the remaining pieces that I needed to complete my G1 Trypticon. So, and there you go. So,
I think it's awesome that they kept the electronics, because, you know, it's kind of been the fate as of, you know, the last decade, strip the electronics and there you go. But it's awesome that they're keeping them. I really want them to redo Gigastorm, but I mean, considering what Gigastorm's price is, I'm better off just getting... Old Gigastorm.
Yeah.
At least with Gigastorm, you have the Sonicon version.
Yeah.
All right, and this is going to be your Takara stuff, so you can see your Transformers Unite Warriors. This is what Jaim is going to be getting.
Actually, I dumped that pre-order.
You did?
Yeah, I went after the Air Gear Air Raptors, the Raptor set, instead of that. So, yeah. Jaim. Sorry. So I know.
You're not going to even get the Hasbro now?
No, I got the Hasbro. I mean, I got Slingshot and all that. I got all those now, but I'm not getting the Takara version.
Okay.
I spent it on something else.
Gotcha.
But the packaging looks so good. kind of. Yeah,
I want, I want the Hasbro in the box set packaging. Mm. And they're all in jet mode. Man, that does look good.
Wasn't like Australia like gonna get this at retail? This version, something I saw on TFW or something.
Probably the people that I shared this from was Planet Icon, and they're Singapore, so.
Oh, it looks good. Oh, well. Probably now I have to pick up the perfect effects. Hands, feet, the white ones.
Yeah, I do like the perfect effects on feet and hands. All right, for Takar, for Defensor. This is something that we kind of talked about a while back, and we were like, well, you know, don't really know. Well, now we do. There's a Groove, going to be a motorcycle. And I can already tell you, it's going to be retold into Rengar, and then your Junkions, and then you. How about Rengar? They upsize it to a Voyager, and you have Rengar as the centerpiece, and then you have your four Junkions, and to where it's just a Junkion combiner. What do you think?
I've been saying that for the very beginning, that they should do that.
They could repaint the Optimus Motormaster mold into like an animated Rengar homage.
Yeah.
Your head. Knock it out that way, too.
I think that's going to be Afterburner.
Yeah, they're going to retool them into that, too. But I like this one. You guys there?
Yeah. Okay. So this is going to be probably another one of the quick slinger breaknecks for Hasbro to get this thing over here. It's going to be one of these exclusives.
Yeah, you know, that was a question that I was talking with some guys, Realm of Collectors, last night in their chat, their hangout. And, you know, it says that this is, you know, the exclusive Defensor or whatever, the exclusive Groove for Defensor. But that's, it's exclusive as it's going to be in that box set, you know, for him coming that way. He's going to be able to get, your Hasbro is going to end up getting him separate, just like they did with the other two guys.
Yeah. This guy doesn't come out until at least October-ish, I think. So, plenty of time to see a reveal sometime.
Probably come, Hasbro's will probably come out around the same time that Takara releases the box set. If not, maybe a little bit earlier.
Yeah.
All right, this is from the Tokyo Toy Show. Their exclusives. So, a few changes with the Armada Megatron. You like it?
Yeah, I mean, it's nice, but I'm fine with the Hasbro release, the US release.
Looks cool.
Yeah, I like that
I'm kind of debating picking that Scourge up, or that, you know, Black Convoy, or whatever they're calling them, just to have one sealed box, you know, compared to my Collector's Club version. It does have, you know, some more paint apps on it, too, which is nice.
It's just weird that this version is, you know, based off of a Collector's Club.
Well, it's
the
funny,
other way around.
This is based off of, like, the cartoon version, and the Collector's Club is based more or less off the toy version, the Japanese toy version.
Oh.
Yeah, so, you know, I don't know, I thought it was neat. You know, fans are finally getting this, like, again, after years of asking.
I hope we can just get the Battle Tanker stuff to go with it. I don't know. I like the Make Toy stuff.
All chrome would be so nice.
All right, getting into the masterpiece, I think this is the only thing we have, but looking at all three modes of Road Rage, oh, man, she's so beautiful.
Oh, Shatterglass Tracks, yeah.
Don't you dare. Yeah, she's
still
she
wish
adorable.
The yeah, does look good.
That red Corvette, dude, oh, my goodness.
Look, and, oh, that's great looking. The Stingray Tracks. Wheels.
Yeah. Tracks I'm for sure picking up. Just because I love the old Corvettes.
There you go. Look at that. Mm, that is great. I love it. I can't wait to have all the Masterpiece stuff give to me. I'm buying it all. They can paint it pink and till. I'll buy it. And just name it name it whatever you want. You can name it Pete. I'll buy it.
Name it Pete.
I think that was it. The picture. I'm not going to get into that. Basically, X-Trans bots on, I believe it is the Cyclonus. People were saying they didn't like the lower part of it, so they're going back to the drawing board to try to adjust some stuff with their 3D render to give you a better product. That was kind of the rundown on that. If you want to read the whole complete little statement there, you can go to the Facebook page, DG1Hextron. All right, getting into the third-party stuff. This is Warbitron WB03. And I believe this is final. Him and the nose cone is final as far as the colors go. So, they look really good. Jaim, have you bought any Warbitron stuff?
No. No, I don't plan on buying any of it. It just doesn't interest me. It's just my opinion. I like make toys if I was going to go that route.
I think that I would go with the make toys route as well. Just because, like, I had this big discussion last night. I was like, you know, I'm kind of getting out of third-party stuff, but if I do buy third-party, I want something that I know that if Hasbro Dakar comes out with it, it's not going to look exactly the same. There's going to be some style to it, like the Mastermind Creations Predaking. Hasbro Dakar is not going to come out with a Predaking that's stylized that way. You know, it's the same thing with Make Toys. You know, they're Quantron. Hasbro Dakar is not going to come out with a, you know, Computron that's stylized that way. So it's still worthy to have in your collection, I think. So, someone also pointed out today on Facebook, they're like, I just can't get over whenever y'all brought up that his missiles are shooting him in the face. So,
yeah.
It's a flaw. Well, I guess you can pull those up. All the other earlier pictures, they had the missiles just shooting them here in the back.
Yeah, like that.
Yeah. It's kind of pointless to have it that way.
That's probably just like a, you know, regular, like, transport mode. No need for it.
Well, hopefully you don't need your missiles.
Well, I mean, why would you have them? Huh? Huh?
All right, and Unique Toys, how do you say that, Jaim?
Unique Toys, Siegfried.
All right, there you go. So we looked at the sky a few weeks ago, and they didn't have all the extra little paint applications. It looks like now they do, so the sky is closer to production. Again, I still like what Unique Toys is doing with this Abominus. It's a huge step up from their Predaking. Huge, huge.
Yeah. He looks good. He looks really good.
There he is, all combined. That's it, yeah.
What
God, who is this one by? Unique Toys. Okay. I can't stop looking at it. That's too long. They need to go back to the drawing board and kind of cut some of this off. Can I freeze up?
No, I can still hear you.
Okay. People in the chat are saying that they're having problems seeing the video and stuff like that. But you're coming out with a masterpiece blur. What do you think about this guy?
It looks okay.
I can't get over this, James. I can't. Every time I look at one of the pictures, I keep on looking at it. It's just it's
okay.
Too big.
Well, now that I see that,
is faster than a speeding bullet still in poor taste?
Whoa!
I'm so like I don't know. I don't dig the masterpiece build stuff. You know what I mean? God, dude, if that was a deluxe, oh, man.
Like, he comes with a little Target Master. You're talking about third-party style masterpiece stuff, right?
Right, right. The masterpiece scaled stuff, I should say.
Yeah. I can't call the third-party masterpiece.
Right. But, I mean, dude, it looks really good, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Aside from a few things.
God, I can't stop.
Dude, keep him away from my RC, Chromie, and all that. Oh man.
Who did the other blur? Was that SXS Toys or something like that?
Yes.
Yeah, you know,
clocking or something.
Yeah. I was actually looking at that on eBay, and you know, because I'm looking for stuff for you know John Machida to sign, and like I looked at United Blur, couldn't get it in time. Yeah, I picked up a Legends RC just for Sue to sign. And I was like, you know, what can I get? Because Animated Blur is way out of the price range. At least the Takara one. It's the only one I could find sealed. But that SXS, you know, it's Voyager size. It's good. You know what I mean? But
I need an Animated Blur.
I have one.
I have one.
Give it to me. we'll make a deal. DX9 Toys released two new images of Kari. You see that you're going to get some diecast there. There's going to be some chrome as well. Dakota, you're a Rodimus collector.
I am. I still am.
You like them?
What scale is this in?
That's Masterpiece style.
See, I already have a Masterpiece Rodimus.
This is supposed to be more of the James takeover here where...
I get it's supposed to be more than meets the eye.
Style, yeah. Whatever.
I know it's supposed to be that, but I want, you know, I'm more or less craving that in the classic styled form and not so much the masterpiece styled form. You know
True.
What I mean?
Yeah. How are your knees, though, on your Rodimus?
Dude, they're fantastic. I guess okay. I just got the one lucky one in the batch because I can still just keep transforming that thing all day long.
Well,
on top of that, there's a Shapeways kit that I know, you know, I have access to in case the knees ever do go bad.
Mm.
So, you know, looking at it that way, I just don't have the need for it. It looks good, but
yeah.
Dalton, dude, Dalton's doing that Cyclonus thing to me again, where he like puts it in front of my face. He just, I have Animated Blur too, Josh.
Wait, just wait until if Dalton gets MP10B.
Oh,
you know what? He's selling everything he has right now just so he can buy it and take like a bunch of pictures and show me. all right, and then you get this picture right here. So.
It is cool to get this one if you never did get the original Takara Rodimus with the trailer and all that.
Even then, do we know how price on this guy yet? Because if he's going to be around that same... Takara MP9 or MP9, yeah, Masterpiece Rodimus. Paul, I don't know. I think you're better off going and getting the official one.
Well, getting the official Rodimus with trailer is a little pricey now, though.
Yeah,
I'm just looking at the Black Convoy for MP9. The Black B Black Convoy was, I think it's 109, or is it 119? Whenever I bought it, so
your Black Convoy was only $120. Wow.
No. $209, $219.
Oh, okay.
Something like that. Yeah.
Whoa.
Let's see. I can get one.
Remember, because I had been drinking with you.
On that hangout, yeah, and I remember.
And then I was like, you know what? I'm going to buy this.
just a quick eBay search. I can get one that's loose for like 117.
Yeah, nobody wants anything loose.
I'll take it loose. I don't need the box.
Loose, which one?
Rodimus, just the masterpiece to car, masterpiece Rodimus with the trailer. It's got everything.
With the trailer.
117.
I just need the trailer for regular MP09.
I don't. I'm curious. Did they ever KO this thing?
Yes.
That might be it.
Yeah.
No.
You can get it out of packaging. You can just get the trailer on its own. Yeah, it's been KO'd.
Okay. I've seen that.
All right. Well, anyways, we got X-Transbots. Their little beachcomber. I don't know what the heck his fake name is, but
beachcomber.
I'm sure it's
the one that killed Blaster. Oh, no, that's cool. There you go.
Yeah, that is pretty sweet.
But Spike needs Carly. Doesn't need to be driving his dad around.
I know, man.
That's funny. You're funny.
God, man, it's got some long, like a little long hill spurs right here.
Stability is key.
Yeah, I guess so. There it is compared to pipes or whatever. Stacks. I forgot what their fake names are.
Too bad he can't transfer it into like an off striker, G.I. Joe. Put that gun on top. For a pacifist, too. To be wielding a machine gun there. Or no, he's a geologist. Yeah.
All right, this is a new third-party company. There's a couple of new third-party companies. There is Voodoo Robots. These are going to... God, what, okay, which one? I don't know if they're Masterpiece or not. They probably are. All the new third-party companies are doing Masterpiece-style size.
Most likely, yeah.
Well, we know that Takara's going to be coming out with these guys pretty soon. So you're a brand new company, and that's what you want to do. You better get them out quick.
Unless they knew something ahead of time. You never know. We're in the same kind of factory. What's going on?
And in their vehicle modes. Cool characters, you know, the robot modes look cool. Not the G1 toys. Those G1 toys are ugly, but not very exciting as a van.
But they're comic book accurate. See, I want my Ironhide to be able to be big enough, masterpiece size, and it's going to be too big, but so I can put my masterpiece Bumblebee in it when he's shooting the little ravine to divert the water or whatever, that one episode of G1.
Oh, yeah, I know what you're talking about. Whenever, what is it, Rumble? He's down there, like, calls him like kind of like an earthquake, dam, and stuff like that. Okay. All right, so Oscular Max is going to be the third Masterpiece-style Insecticon set. So here we had a few weeks ago to where Fans Toys doing one, Bad Cube's doing one. Now they're doing one all within a month's period. I can almost tell you that you will probably get Masterpiece, like official Insecticons, probably in 2016. Mark my word. All right? You can put me down for it.
All right, let me write that down here.
Yep, 2017 rolls around, and they haven't said that they're coming out with Masterpiece Insecticons. You can let me know about it.
I'm going to go a step further. You have to admit that Beast Wars is the superior brand.
But,
if it doesn't happen, you become a Beast Wars collector.
Okay, I'm not going that far.
Oh, but what?
You're just pushing it now.
Now, if this is a Masterpiece figure, now, I would love for a company to come out with their bombshell and have a little accessory pack that it comes with, which has new heads for, like, Soundwave and some other Masterpiece characters that actually have the Cerebro shell that you can kind of see there, that you can kind of put on. I think that would be kind of a nice nod. But, oh, I like that. And it's dead silent.
Oh, I'm trying. Okay, here we go. I do not... I'm not a big fan of the kickback. But I'm not going to try to bash anything. We don't know if this is final, but not a big fan of him.
Love the shades. Seems like kickback is the one that always doesn't look the best out of the three. It's always that kind of crappy member.
Yeah, out of the three third-party ones that are out, I like the fans' toys the most. Again, you know, this is just, you know, like prototype here, so I'm sure that, you know, he will be able to support himself eventually. And here you have all three. So up here you have Bad Cube, Fans Toys, and what's that? Muscular Max.
And which one's coming in a three pack?
Bad Cubes. It's okay. Going to be a three pack. Fans Toys is going to be individually, and we don't know yet on these guys. Trying to rapid fire through this stuff. This is also Spark Toys with a War Within Optimus Prime. This thing is going to be about MP08 Masterpiece Grimlock size.
Glad to see someone tackling the War Within stuff.
Hopefully they do Megatron.
It's pretty cool looking.
Because it would really suck to invest in this.
And they get more of
them. At least a Megatron or, you know, some of the other characters.
I mean, to make it that big, though, exactly where would you put that thing? You know, I would think you'd put it kind of like with your Fall of Cybertron, War for Cybertron stuff, or? It's just still be really big over there. All right, and this is from Hero Hobby. This adorable looking little Grimlock.
Of course.
Oh, look how cute he is, man. His tail even moves, and he transforms.
Guys, we're losing
That's the best SD figure so far. It transforms as the articulation. There you go. It's adorable. I might get this right here. But even his little bitty blaster is, like, really small. I like this guy. What do you guys think?
Does he come with a sword?
Doesn't show that.
It's cool that it transforms.
Yeah, I think that's awesome. All right, another little smaller guy. This is DX9's Warren Pocket Hulky, which is going to be a combiner, so just a little update picture of him. This one actually looks really good, too.
Glad to see they're still doing those like smaller Legends scale style stuff to kind of go with your Fall of Cybertron Metroplex.
Yeah. I wish they'd do the Dinobots. That would be cool.
Yeah, they do need those. Or, do you remember Machine Boy? The one that was supposed to come out with an Omega, a Masterpiece style Omega Supreme, or I don't know if it was Masterpiece style, but an Omega Supreme, a Skylynx, and they said, what was it? They were Dialysis. Yeah, they were coming out with Dialysis, and Astral Train. So this is actually going to be for your chug shelf. So it's going to be, I think, about 8 inches or somewhere around there. That's what it was. It doesn't seem here, but I think it's supposed to basically go with your chug shelf. I only have the picture of it here, and it's robot mode. But kind of giving you a G1 kind of looking Astro Train for your chug shelf. You like that?
Hmm. Yeah.
All right, Perfect Effect, they are coming out with their own little guy. I'm not interested in this. I'll keep mine original, but I'm doing comparison shots. Jamie's sticking original, correct?
Yeah, I don't need that.
I'm sticking with the original, too, because don't forget I have it.
Oh, you do, Mr. Beast Wars?
Yes, I do. Remember, I got it on that Cybercast 1000 Star Saber free giveaway.
Oh, that free giveaway thing that we did that no one else knew about.
Yeah, I don't know how no one else did. I don't know how I was the only one that knew about it. But
This is KFC's Rover. I thought they announced this thing like a long time ago, but they just put these pictures up like a couple weeks ago. So,
How come KFC can't do Decibone Legout? Done everyone else. Get those guys going. I'd actually buy those. I wouldn't have to mess with the original.
I guess that's the picture, though. I saw, like I think I saw this picture, like, over a year ago.
There's so many cassettes. Like, there's so many cassettes I never knew about. You know what I mean?
Well, this guy was in one of the episodes, but it was, like real short. Like, someone reminded me of, like, on the Facebook of which episode it was. I just forgot what it was.
But. Whoa.
All right, X-Trans bots, kind of just showing some mock-ups, but, you know, they've got this thing pretty much, you know, kind of put together. It's got light up right here, the little target master guy. It's going to have the little thing where you can actually pop his head up. Or you can put this down so it's showing his head, just like it did several times in the animated cartoon, which didn't make any sense, but it was there, so we wanted it. Anytime like they make screw ups in the G1 cartoon, we're like, yep, if they make this, I want that screw up in there, you know. This guy looks really good though, really, yeah, really, really good.
It's cool that he came with the Target Master to do.
Yep. Like, I'll like him a lot. And he's got his fingernails painted and everything, too. Yeah, so. All right, and this one got a lot of love whenever I shared it on the Facebook page. This is a new company as well. This is TNR. This is going to be TR-01. It's going to be Masterpiece Scale as well. What was that actual? Okay.
Transform and Roll is what they're called. I love that.
I guess it's their motto, just like Clone Droid, always be your side. Just some mock-ups right now. What do you think?
Makes me want to jazz.
Looks like Alex. Looks like they're gonna have options where you can like put the doors
that's
down.
That's cool. To deal with the doors. I think that's neat.
Options. Options are always good.
Yeah.
And you can see you got the little hook here that he uses in the cartoon.
Oh, that's cool. Wow.
And what scale is this again?
This is going to be Masterpiece Scale.
Ah, of course.
More stuff from the cartoon.
I'm just surprised that Blaster never rolled around with Jazz. Always with tracks.
Yeah.
But, man, this really, I really want, or let's put it this way, I'm really hoping Takara is making a jazz if we're getting this guy, maybe. But, man, this looks good.
Wait a second. I don't think they spelled Porsche back there correctly. I'm seeing that, right?
For a reason.
Master P-O-R-S-C-N-E?
Porsche. Yeah.
Porsche name. Master Porsche name.
Master Porsche name.
Oh, you're definitely going to need some repro labels for this guy. That would get on my nerves. I wouldn't be...
They couldn't even put Meister on there.
Yeah, you know what? It would have been best not to even put anything on there, and then people are going to have to get repro labels. I just saw that, too. I was like...
Oh, there we go.
All right, Master of My Creations, R18.
Coulter?
Is that right? No.
Tarn.
Oh, wow. Who the heck is this guy supposed to be?
Tarn? Yeah. DJD.
That's it.
Is this some IDW thing?
Yeah, it's over. That's all I need, and I'm done. All
right.
That's it.
So, have they already come out with their great shot?
No.
Oh, they canceled it.
What?
No, I'm just joking. I wanted to see James say anything.
I was just like, because that's dude, I'm actually looking
like my new like favorite third party company now.
I'm actually looking forward to I'm looking forward to picking up that great shot because I didn't get Hextron, didn't have a place for Hextron, but I may have a place for a great shot.
Next year, Star Saber.
All right, and this is part of the masterpiece Zoids. I believe that's what it is. Yeah, and this is the 1/100th. How do you say that? Mirasimi. Liger or something like that.
Yeah, I can see it.
Dude, Zoids have come a long way since I watched that cartoon as a kid. Wow.
Or a Masa something.
Oh, guys, it's just Perfect Effects Live Con.
Yep, which is next month.
It's another one I'm looking forward to.
Oh,
no, that's nice.
Hey,
that's
scratch his little chin. Hey, little kitty. Hey, little kitty.
You should cut yourself. All those jagged, sharp edges. That looks nice, though.
I'm I'm a sucker for like the little poses like that. I'm also a cat person, so I like kitties.
You heard it here. Josh is an old cat lady.
Oh. Palmy. That was cool.
Is that what that is?
Yeah, I don't know. It's just he's got his paw up just like, okay.
My cat doesn't ever do that. On the thing, the sword rotates on there, so I guess it just cuts people up while it's running through the forest, I guess.
Oh, that's kind of cool, though.
Yeah.
It's pretty sweet looking.
Yeah.
Alright, getting into the add-ons, I believe. Is it the add-ons yet? Yeah, so add-ons.
Nice.
This is Melzy Balls. This is actually up for pre-order already. Someone asked me but you can get it. It's up for pre-order. Well, add-on sets.
That's really cool.
Pretty nicely detailed, too.
Yeah. Wish mine came with the...
And he's got, like, a little headset thing here, too.
That's part of the set?
I'm guessing. I thought it was just these two things here, but I see this headset here, and... That's Frenzy, that's Rumble. I just wanted to...
Well, if you read the IDW comics, that fellow right there is Frenzy.
Nope, that's Rumble. Rumble's purple.
See what that's Frenzy in IDW comics?
Nope, you go back to the G1 cartoon.
Where they're always messing up things.
Yes. That's what we hang our hat on, as far as what's the facts in Transformers.
Yeah, Frenzy being blue, Rumble being red.
Nope, we go to the cartoon. Anyways, moving on. This is also by Belzeboss, Iron Lady. Thanks. You get a little bit different stuff for Chromia here. Some stuff.
Oh, there's
the Buster Sword. Look at it.
Nice.
Oh, man.
RC and Windblade. Blue. There's another one for Chromia.
Dude.
Yeah, that's
wow.
Sweet.
That is freaking awesome.
That other thing was Belzeboss as well, so, I mean, they're coming out with some pretty cool-looking stuff.
Yeah.
Well, they've always had some really good stuff.
Really makes me want to pick up Chromia. You know, it's something else I don't really have a place for, but looks great.
No, Tulala. That's not right.
What?
The toys had it wrong. The cartoon had it correct.
Dude, I'm so glad Tulala is at least on my side.
Everybody knows that Frenzy is red, Rumble is blue or purple, whatever you want to call them. All right, getting into head robots. This is the Green King Kit 2. This is for your Botcon Scorponok. So you get some chest pieces and the little chrome things down here.
This is the company that's doing like a bunch of the like separate add-on packs, right?
Yes, yeah. So this is just King 2, or the Kit 2.
Right.
They have several other ones, so like that way I do like it. That way, if you're like, hey, you know, hey, we're coming out with these 10 pieces, but you only wanted to put like 6 of them on, then you don't have just like these like 4 pieces. You're not gonna, you know, use. That way you can be like, hey, I only like Kit 2, I only like Kit 4. You know, that way you don't have to spend money on the other stuff.
Yeah.
This is also by Head Robots that I'll ever pull up. Infiltrator upgrade. This is for your...
Oh, Toy World.
Is it Toy World? Okay.
Yeah.
That's obviously cool. This is going to be painted. It's going to look like this. You're going to have stickers that you're going to be able to put in there. And upcoming from Dr. Wu, they're going to be doing Carly. Wait, is that Carly?
Yeah.
Yeah. And we've already gone almost 2.5 hours, so this, what I was going to discuss, that topic, we will do that next week.
What? I saw Lau Kaiser.
What? Yeah, we're going to do that topic next week.
Oh.
Yeah.
People wanted it.
I know they did, but man, AfriCast is right after this, and remakes. But I do have one question here. This is from Tanner of TD's Collectible Toys. Since Masterpiece Star Saber was successful, do you think Takara will release more Japanese or maybe even other lines like Beast War, Armada, etc. in the future? Dakota, you're a Beast War fan.
You know, seeing as how like Star Saber was, you know, very popular, and so far, I believe, has done really well as far as sales go. He was also a fan-voted combiner, and he won by, like, a landslide, too, didn't he? I think that was kind of a no-brainer for that to happen. As far as doing other Japanese masterpieces, if they get around to them, it'll be long after the main cast has come and gone. If I see them doing any other Japanese masterpieces, like, immediately, it would be Victory Leo. Just, you know, for obvious reasons. But, Beast Wars, you know, I would love Beast Wars masterpieces. I just don't see it happening. Like, maybe even ever, you know, but that's just me.
I'd like it, but I just don't see it. I don't see it as being something feasible.
No, I don't think so either. I mean, look at Generation 1, the years just in itself, from 1984 all the way to 1992. No. If they're going to, you know, stick with that realm. They might, but I'll be in a retirement home with dementia probably at the age of 80, 85. I don't think it's going to happen. I mean, it has to be a fan-voted thing.
Yeah.
And we haven't had another one for a while, which is kind of odd.
Well, it's only been a year, right?
Yep. Well, they should have already said that we're going to be doing a fan-voted thing, because we had, you know, the fan-voted thing was in 2014, correct? And they, so, for if they, we were going to have one for 2016, they would have had to let us know about it right about now. That, hey, we're at fan vote for a figure in 2016, just to make it to where it'd be an every other year.
Right.
So if we don't have it in the next month and a half, 2 months, let's say 2 months, that they say, hey, we're having another fan voted thing, then it won't be until 2017 until you would actually see the figure.
And that fan vote was also based on, like, people that actually bought Takara stuff, too.
Yes, that's all Takara stuff.
The mail-in, you know, that they would have to do, yeah, you know. It may have just been a one-off for the anniversary. Maybe we'll see it again in 5 years, you know, who knows.
How do you like that? Wait 5 years for Victory Leo.
Better than 30.
Or 10, you know what I mean? I don't think Victory Leo would be a fan vote, though. I think that's just gonna...
You gotta give it to us.
I think it's gonna happen regardless. You know?
I mean, because Takara, it's not like they really care what, you know, about Hasbro whenever it comes to the Masterpiece line, so they're just gonna... Takara's gonna do what they want to do for their fans, and just sometimes you're fortunate enough to get it over to the Hasbro side of it. Got, let's see, one question on here from Chevytron951 says, what other mecha have you guys watched besides what you have mentioned on the Cybercast? I don't really watch any mecha, so. Jaim, that's probably more of you, maybe someone in Dakota.
I've watched several stuff. I mean, Gundams, whatever else anime that has mecha stuff in it. You range from like Full Metal Panic, Neon Genesis Evangelion, to Web Diver, Digunder, I don't know.
Escaflowne, I remember Escaflowne.
Yeah. Escaflowne, Diguard, Gunbuster.
Big O.
Yeah, I could sit here for days. Reading what I got behind
all,
me.
All that stuff you see, like all that right there. So, Cameron, nice for you to join us. I know that like sometimes the Central Standard Time can be a little confusing for people overseas. I mean, it's confusing for people that live here in the States. So, we usually start the show as of right now about 2.5 hours ago. So, just letting you know there. Now, we are going to be doing the aftercast. Jaim, are you going to be doing that, kicking it off at 9, or are you going to do it at 9:15, 9:30?
I can do it at 9:30 if you guys want. Give us more, a little more of a more time.
Just I'm primal, kind of hungry.
So, or how about 9:15?
9:15 is fine.
Okay.
9:15, we can do that.
So. All right, so why don't you go ahead and plug everything again, and then we'll shout out our stuff and... We'll be gone.
Yeah. So, Aftercast will be on today at 9:15, guys, on my channel. You can find me, VictorySaber77, YouTube, Twitter, and also next week, Cybercast and Aftercast will be actually on Sunday. It's just that Sunday. It's not going to be regularly on Sunday, but it's normal time, 6 p.m. Central Standard Time for the Cybercast, 9 p.m. Central Standard Time for the Aftercast. And if you want your collection spotlight, we're doing that on the Cybercast. Just keep your pictures between 10 to 20, and we will showcase you on the Cybercast. And if you want to sponsor, we're also looking for a sponsor, too. So with all that, just email Josh at g1hexatron@gmail.com. And all the new stuff that we talked about and the movie stuff is located on Josh's Facebook page, the G1 Hexatron. And that's it.
A couple of things. Tulala says, is Primal going to be on the AfterCast?
Primal?
The other thing is Dalton TF says at least Trent will be on time because it's 9:15. Sorry,
Trent's always just gets nailed.
All right. So, anyways, Primal, where can people find you, man?
Primal Sabbath. I own Primal Selfish LLC. It's a great company to work for. And yeah.
And you find me, G1Xtron, on Twitter, YouTube, Instagram, and my Facebook page is the G1Xtron. We had Pete Sinclair of Botcon on earlier today, you know, kind of going over some of the Botcon stuff. So that was pretty much the first hour of the show. So we did a little bit different. If this is your first time watching one of our shows, then we did a little bit different this episode than we did all the previous ones. So, you know, if you like what you see, then, you know, come back next week and we'll have plenty to talk about and plenty to show you. So thanks a lot for watching, guys. Hopefully you enjoy. We'll talk to you guys later. AfterCast is going to be in about, if you can't figure out the time differences, about 45 minutes from now. So talk to you guys then. Peace.
See ya. Later.